message this morning titled, How Does God Direct His Paths in Your Life? How does God direct His paths in your life? Many a times we are trying to follow our own paths, our own ways. But remember, if you are a child of God, God has His path for you in your life. So how does God direct His path in your life? So go with me to Proverbs chapter 3. You would have read these verses many times, or you would have heard messages sometimes. But there are deep truths in that, in those verses. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6, please. Book of Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct thy paths. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge Him, and He shall direct thy path. The same verses, if you read it in the Amplified Version, I want to read that in Amplified Version so that you'll understand more. It says, Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6, lean on, trust Him, and be confident in the Lord with all your heart and mind. And do not rely on your own insight or understanding. In all your ways, know, recognize, and acknowledge Him. And He will direct and make straight and plain your paths. Lean on, trust Him, and be confident in the Lord with all your heart. So it's very simple message. The conditions are given there in those two verses for Lord to direct His paths in our lives. What we should do, first of all, is in verse 5, you should trust in Him with all your heart. Trust in Him with all your heart. The Amplified Version which I read, it says, lean on, trust Him, and be confident in the Lord with all your heart and mind. So it says, lean on, trust Him, and be confident. We must lean on Him. We must trust in Him and also be confident. If I go further, the word trust involves confidence in the character, also ability, agenda of the person you put your trust in. You must trust in His character. So we must trust in the character of Jesus. We must trust in the ability of Jesus or the agenda of Jesus. Believe in His wisdom and ability to guide you. We must totally believe in His wisdom. We must say, Lord, You have the wisdom to guide me because I am Your child. So it's easy to say, yes, I trust in the Lord. Or if I ask that question, all of you will say, Pastor, I trust in the Lord. But remember, the first condition there is, you should trust in Him with all your heart. With all your heart. At times, we do not trust in Him with all our heart. Sometimes we are afraid of taking the first step of trusting in Him. We are afraid. I can share my experience in trusting Him. I came to the Lord in 1979. But 1980, when Jesus, in His grace, when He first filled me with His Holy Spirit, that day itself, God spoke to me very clearly and said, I have called you for your ministry. I have called you for my ministry. I have called you as a full-time minister. But it took time. It took about 11 years for me to trust Him totally. In 1991 only, I totally trust Jesus. What I'm saying is, God wants you to trust Him with all your heart. We are afraid of taking the first step of trusting Him. Many times we go to man and trust in him. But we do not trust in God who has given His Son for us. That is His love. He has given His only Son for us. So we can definitely trust in Him because He has brought us from darkness to light. So we must trust in Him. Also we must remember, we grieve the Holy Spirit when we do not trust in God. The Holy Spirit is the third person of the Trinity. We grieve Him when we do not trust in our God. So God wants us to trust Him with all our heart and mind. That means without any condition, without any reservation. Hallelujah. Sometimes you would have spoken to Him and said, oh Lord, if you do this, I will trust you. No, without any reservation and without any condition, God wants you to trust Him. That is the whole heart and whole mind. All of your heart and all of your mind. You can say this way, it is 100% trust. Not even 99.99999, no. 100% trust. In the natural sense, this could be dangerous if you put that kind of trust in a person with imperfections. But we know our God is a perfect God. He has all power. He has given His very life for us. Because of that, we can trust Him with all our heart and all our mind. Amen. Hallelujah. Our God, thankfully, because of God's perfection, His unchangeable character, His reputation and His unlimited power, we can trust Him with all our hearts and mind. Malachi chapter 3 and verse 6 says, Lord says, for I am the Lord, I change not. I am the Lord, I change not. That means His love never changes. He's the same God. His power never changes. The same power is available even today. Matthew chapter 19 and verse 26, please. Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. With men, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. In other words, God is all powerful. Because He is all powerful, He has unlimited power, we can trust Him. Trust Him. So when we trust in the Lord, our confidence, also security, even our provision, also even our protection is there in the Lord. Amen. Daily we can have our confidence in Him. Also, we have the security in Him. So He will provide for us. Well, at the beginning we read the psalm, Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You will never lack anything because He will provide for us because we are trusting in Him. This makes us safe and secure. Are you safe and secure this morning? If you trust Him totally, wholeheartedly, you will be safe and secure. Safe and secure about your future. Safe and secure about the things you are doing. If you are trusting Him with all heart and all mind. So that's the first thing. Secondly, The same verse, going back to Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. While trusting the Lord, you should not lean unto your own understanding. You should not lean unto your own understanding. Amplified version says, do not rely on your own insight or understanding. Because according to your own understanding, you may choose the wrong path. But remember, if you trust in Him with all heart and all mind, you will never choose the wrong path. Amen. So, both are connected. If you trust in Him 100% with all your heart and all your mind, you will never go astray. Amen. Hallelujah. Even if you want to take a wrong decision, God will somehow or other direct you to the correct path because you are trusting Him totally. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we are living in this world with unbelievers and many unbelieving friends, they may give you many suggestions and you will get confused if you listen to their ideas or suggestions. So because of many ideas and suggestions, many a times we are confused. So how do you overcome that? How we can overcome not relying on our own ideas? The only way is just go to your closet and pray to Him. Commit your ways into His hands. Then you will not lean unto your own understanding. Psalm 37 and verse 5, please. Psalm 37 and verse 5.
Commit thy way unto the Lord.
Trust also in Him. He shall bring it to pass. Commit thy way unto the Lord. Commit your ways into His hands. Then God will open only that way you have to go on. And He will close the other ways before you. Always remember, God is a good God. Amen. He wants you to prosper. He wants you to have good things in your life. But many a times our vision are limited. We don't think. But God's vision for each and every one of us is unlimited. Unlimited. Hallelujah. I can say this way. Our vision is always short-sighted. But God's vision is far-sighted. We may think for today what we have to do or tomorrow, but God is thinking about our whole life. God goes ahead of us and prepares everything for us. Amen. Even you are seated here today, the 8th of February 2015, but God would have planned for you even for next year. God is like that. Hallelujah. The only condition is, are you trusting Him with all your heart and all your mind? Also, second is, don't lean on your own understanding. Thirdly, the same portion of scripture, in all your ways, you have to acknowledge Him. Not in some ways, all your ways, all your decisions, bring Him, acknowledge Him. The word acknowledge involves recognition of authority or status of something that is real, genuine, and credible. So we know God's authority is real and genuine and credible. Because of that, we can acknowledge Him. Also, it is also an agreement and verbal acceptance of something. So acknowledge Him in all your ways. You all might be knowing this verse, Romans chapter 10 and verse 9. Romans chapter 10 and verse 9. Thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus.
Thou shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead. Thou shalt be saved.
Yeah. So the Amplified Version says, because if you acknowledge and confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and in your heart believe, adhere to, trust him, and rely on the truth that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But if you acknowledge and confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, when we acknowledge him with your lips and confess with your heart, also believe in your heart that he has been raised from the dead, you will be saved. So acknowledge. To acknowledge is a strong declaration of God with us. Also God in us, and also God for us. I'll repeat that. To acknowledge means the strong declaration of God with us. We say God, Emmanuel, he is with us. True. Also God is for us. He is not against us. Also God is in us. He lives inside us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It places God as your most high in all your circumstances, and greater than all that can come against you. You may be facing some circumstances this morning. So if you can acknowledge truly from your heart, then that will put you greater than all that you can again, all that can come against you. Amen. So acknowledge, not in some ways, not in major decisions, but all your ways, all your decisions, acknowledge him. In other words, talk to him and make your decisions. Shall we read Isaiah chapter 30, verses 20 and 21? Book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verses 20 and 21.
No, Lord, give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers remove you to a corner anymore, but thine eyes shall see that teacher. And thine ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. And when ye turn to the right hand, and when ye turn to the left.
Amen. So God will guide your path. You will hear from behind, saying, this is the way, walk in it. If you trust in him, he will direct you. There may be still afflictions or confusion for you, but your eyes shall see thy teachers, that is servants of God, who the Lord sends you away to comfort and guide you. Also the word of God is there to comfort and guide you. So he is with you in all your ways because you have trusted in him with all your heart and mind. Even if you have some problems in your life, if you face some circumstances you are unable to bear, but in those circumstances too, acknowledge him because he is with you. If you are totally trusting in him, you have to acknowledge him. So if you acknowledge him in everything, he will direct your path. So again, going back to that verse, at times we trust him with all our heart and mind, but do not acknowledge him in all our ways. Amen. But all three are connected. So if you do not acknowledge him in all our ways, we may lose sight of the destination God is taking us. Also, God cannot help us in such a situation because we have not acknowledged him in all our ways. So God wants us to acknowledge him in all our ways. For example, if God has promised you healing, what do you have to do? You have to claim it and reach the destination by faith. God has already given everything for us. Christ Jesus has already finished his work on the cross of Calvary for you. Christ Jesus died on the cross, not only for our salvation, but also for delivering us from our sicknesses and from our problems. Isaiah 64 and verse 4, please. Book of Isaiah 64 and verse 4.
Since the beginning of the world, men have not heard, nor perceived by the ear, neither hath the eye seen, O God, beside thee, what he hath prepared for him that waiteth for him.
Amen. So he has prepared something that is more than our understanding. It has not, we have not heard, not perceived by the ear, neither had our eyes seen what God has prepared for us. So he has greater things for you. Remember that. Amen. So the three things for God to direct our path. First of all, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and all thy mind. Secondly, lean not unto your own understanding. Thirdly, in all your ways, acknowledge. Acknowledge. Are you doing that? There are many examples in the Word of God. But I want to take you to an old example. And I want to close with that. Can you go with me to Daniel chapter 3? Daniel chapter 3, verses 16 to 18. There you can see, Israelites were taken captive to Babylon. There are some youth, young people were taken. Can you read from 16 to 18?
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego
answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar,
we are not careful to answer thee in this matter.
We are not careful to answer thee in this matter.
Be so, our God, who we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine hand, O king. But if not, be known unto thee, O king, and we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up.
So you can see those three young people, they were totally trusting the Lord. They were saying, we will never bow to the image you have created. Because we know our God. We trust in our God. We are not leaning on our own understanding. If they have leaned on their own understanding, they would have said, okay, King, we are bowing the image. But they didn't do that. They were not leaning on their own understanding. They were trusting totally the Almighty God. They know he will deliver them. Even though, also they were saying, but if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods. See the trust they have. What happened if you read from verses 21 to 25? Verses 21 to 25, the same chapter, Daniel chapter 3.
And these men were bound in their coats, their hosens, and their hats, and their other garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Therefore, because the king's command was urgent, the furnace was exceeding hot, and the flame of the fire slew those men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down, bound into the midst of the burning fire furnace. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished, and rose up to make these things, and said unto his counselors, did not we cast three men down into the midst of the fire? They answered and said to the king, true, O king. He answered and said, lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt.
Amen. The form of the fourth is like the Son of God. So in the fiery furnace, the Son of God was in there. Hallelujah. So they totally trusted in the Almighty God. They didn't lean on their own understanding. Hallelujah. Also they acknowledged their God. So if you can do these three things, I believe that is God's desire, then God will direct your path in your day-to-day life. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and all thy mind. And lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him. Then you will see he shall direct your path every day. Hallelujah. You will never go astray. So shall we stand to our feet and look to the Lord?